Baltimore's mayor says the new police commissioner, Dr. Joel Fitzgerald, from the Fort Worth, Texas Police Department, could start after Thanksgiving. But will he? And what's going to be the process up until that point? Here to talk about that with us is C4. He's host of the C4 show. You can hear him every day here on WBAL News Radio 1090. So there is a bit of the city council wants to get involved.
Well, I said before, when the mayor put this whole process in place, Phil, very secretively, not involving the city council, I thought that was a mistake. Not just not involving the city council, not involving many of the major stakeholders. You know, we have a consent decree that's in place. So when you do it this way secretively, you expect blowback from the very people who have to confirm your appointment. They do have the role of advice and consent as a city council. So they're going to make this trip for the council members down to Texas. I don't know what they're going to find, but they feel an obligation to do this.
And what do you think they're going to find? Well, you said you don't know, but what do you think? What kind of question are they going to be asking?
Exactly. I mean, look, apparently Dr. Fitzgerald has been heading up this department since 2015. They had a homicide count of 70 last year, which was a 20% increase over the year before, and they were disappointed. That's all I really care about. This commissioner, this chief, is used to very, very tough police departments and keeping crime at a minimum. That's the major thing right now.
But again, Baltimore has a different set of circumstances than any other city in the country.
But expectations, what I'm talking about, Phil, we have had commissioners in here that when we go from 340 down to 318, they go, that's an improvement. I don't think this commissioner is going to see that as an improvement. The expectation should be that we are under 100 or at that level. Washington, D.C., largest city in us right down the road, barely 100 homicides. And they used to be the murder capital of the country like we are. So I want those type of expectations coming in.
Are you surprised about this whole process? Because remember, we heard this name
Back to the future is what I called it. Yeah. Back to the future.
And we were told, well, no, it's not official just yet. And
that's because their mayor somebody, Betsy Price,
she slipped along the way, right? And then we got a response in fact from the mayor that day saying, you know.
Well, however it happened, here's where we are today. And my thing is, city council should, as quickly as they can, do their due diligence, go ahead and do all, and vote. Let's get this guy on board. And my major thing, Phil, let's give this commissioner at least a year. Let him implement his changes. Let him bring his own personnel with him. Because right now, what we're doing is failing. We're doing right now is not working.
Interim Commissioner Tuggle said that he didn't want the job for a couple of reasons. One, he said, I don't have the time commitment. He said, it's going to take 5 years.
He was also told by the mayor, you're not getting it. That helped him, too.
Well,
that helped his decision-making
right, but,
as
but
well.
He said it's going to take a long time. I mean, right. he's knee-deep in the weeds down there at the police commissioner's office. Is
this
it going
take
to take a couple
time.
Of years?
Oh, no, this is going to take more than. I said, when the mayor was first running, and they, all the mayoral candidates, and they were in studio, I said, are you committed to 10 years? Because in terms of turning the city around, Phil, we need a 10-year plan. We didn't get here overnight. We've been the heroin capital of America since the 70s. So we didn't get here overnight. We need somebody committed to a long-term approach to turn us around.
I still say you should have taken the job, but you didn't want to throw your name in the hat.
I run from things now, Phil. I don't run for anything.
All right, C4, you can hear him every day here on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5 and the free WBAL app every day from 9 until 1 here on WBAL. Thanks, C4.
Thank you.